Islamabad from Allah calling me. His Excellency Ali Al-Izadeh, presidents of Azerbaijan, at Kashmir Green from Bradford University, head of the department, social sciences department, respected faculty members, my dear students, Assalamu alaikum and very warm after talking about it. It's really, we are honored, sir, with your presence here today at Paris. And we are also grateful to the head of the Development Studies, Dr. Abdul-Azhar, and his colleagues for organizing this wonderful event here today. Sir, while you are going through your discourse about the child protection and the woman protection and the rights of the child and woman, I was looking in the past how Pakistan also went through the same experience as in Azerbaijan. We have also historically grown in this respect, and in Pakistani constitution under Article 25A, it is incumbent upon the state to provide free and equal education to all children in Pakistan up to the age of 16, that is continuing education. So we are actually constitutionally and legally bound to provide education free to all our children in Pakistan, regardless of their gender. Another similarity is about the child protection. I played the part of the legislation piece which was developed during the year 2003 and 4, and it is by virtue of which we had child protection bureaus in all over Pakistan. And these child protection bureaus are actually working on the issue of those children between any age up to the age of 16. But the problem is very grave in Pakistan. And the problem which we are facing is stunning. To talk about the health issues. Health is one area which is very, very weak, and we need to work diligently on that. And we would definitely like to be benefited from the Azerbaijan experience there. And I think direction is right. Because stunning is such a great problem in Pakistan that 40% of our children, they suffer from stunning problems. And that is a real issue in Pakistan. That is a real, real, real issue. The second big issue and challenge which we are facing here in Pakistan is that almost 29 million out of school. These children have never seen the school what is a classroom like, what are the four bounds of the classroom, what is the tradition in the classroom, how it looks like. We have never experienced it. That is the challenge of my country. That is the challenge which we are facing, and we are working very diligently on that. And why I'm telling this? Because these youngsters who are sitting here, tomorrow they'll be taking the reins of this country, and they need to be aware of what are the challenges which they are facing. And the problem is so huge. I often say that every 10th illiterate person in the world resides in Pakistan. Every 10th illiterate person resides in Pakistan. That is my challenge. That is the challenge of the generation of this country. That is the challenge of. And sir, we'll definitely, Your Excellency will take the advantage of the Azerbaijan experience in that regard and see to it how we can work together in that direction to achieve 100% literacy, universal health care, not only for children but all citizens of Pakistan. That is one area I call accumulation of social capital. In my discourse, I often call it accumulation of social capital. And we need to invest in that. And we need to invest very consciously. If you see this university where you are sitting here, it's a non-profit organization. We work on entirely on neck-to-neck basis. Whatever we receive, we spend more on our students just to provide them the quality education. This is how we are working. And this is one model which we are actually helping with the government to actually work in the private sector and the corporate sector to work on that. I take the advantage of presence of and if you want to use the platform of SZABIST here, and you can work on this area with our social science department here. I'm taking the advantage of this platform and today, since you are here. So it's an offer from ZBS. If you want to, we can actually associate some of our students and faculty with part of your project if you want to work on the child protection. Dr. Rashida is already here. She is a renowned scholar here and a researcher. And you can always associate with her and in the field with Dr. Abdul-Razak and many other faculty members who are here. And thank you very much for being with us today here at this gathering. So this is the challenge. So what is the take home? This is our usual discourse. We ask our students what the take home. So our take home is treat everybody with respect, with dignity. Whether it's a child, an old age parent, your colleague, male, female, no biases. And all of you know that in SZABIST, we not only educate, we train also. And we are very proud of it that my students, they are, mashallah, one of the best well-trained students in whole of Pakistan. That I can say very good. And I'll end with this, that we celebrate diversity. That is our one of main areas in which we train our students here. His Excellency, thank you very much. Prof. Saiba, thank you very much to be with us here today. Thank you very much indeed. Yes.
Advocate Huma Jameel. Qureshi. Gathered in front of the new building gates for a symbolic awareness walk and a photograph.